And hello everyone. Well, that's the last day of the Challenge Cup stage in Minsk. It flew so fast by that I didn't even notice. This one of the last big world-class tournaments. The Challenge Cup will also take place in Moscow in a week, but even fewer teams will come to it. I'll go inside and gain strength for Tokyo. Well, what about the last day in Minsk, which was interesting? What is better and who won? I will tell you in this video. Well, before starting, do not forget to subscribe to the channel so as not to miss new videos. While using the link in the description, you can support me with donations. Thank you very much to those who are already sending them. I'm very pleased and it really motivates. I really appreciate it. So a big hug to all of you. Now for the fun part. And I'll start today with some unpleasant moments. Competitions today started from the 12th in the day, and the previous 2 days there was a wonderful broadcast, about which I spoke in my videos. But today the problems began. Firstly, there was no broadcast on Europe, and it was written in the official Instagram account of the Belarusian Gymnastics Federation that the International Gymnastics Federation, IGF, prohibits broadcasting such tournaments on the YouTube channel. I think this is due to the fish does it itself, but for some reason this time there was no broadcast from them. And in general, I was really angry about what kind of a development of gymnastics it was when I didn't see the finals. So what that? And usually just with them there are no problem. But special thanks to the Belarusian Gymnastics Federation for the first 2 days. And it's a shame for the finals that the International Gymnastics Federation is putting a spoke on its wheels and hindering the development of gymnastics. Well, that's half the trouble. Organizers promised the broadcast on the Belarus 5 TV channel, and everything would be fine if the majority of gymnastics lovers did not live in Russia. For the TV channel is mostly blocked by some of our federal law, and various VPN did not work, and I tried it through Singapore, Poland, United States. In general, the main links did not work in any way, or there were those that were slow, and in fact I spent almost the entire final with the hoop trying to find working links of the Belarus 5 TV channel, which are shown in Russia. Fortunately, they were found later, and for Russia, from 1 PM they began broadcasting for the arena match. In general, I was really naturally nervous and wrecked, and it seems like the 21st century and the century of a pandemic when everything goes online and still some kind of technical problems. I do not understand that. Well, the commentators at first, well, now about the commentators. At first I watched the broadcast on Belarus 5 and then switched to the match arena. It is still more usual to watch there and the lag was less. I was able to compare the commentators of Belarus and Russia. So I think it's also an interesting point. I remember at some tournament I complained a lot about the commentators in Belarus that they were very biased and said that only their gymnasts were the best and the rest were bad. And a similar situation was recently on the Russian channel. Well, what did we face this time? It's very difficult to comment on the competitions. I did it myself so I know what I'm talking about, but people who talk about gymnastics always want impartiality, and so that the viewer forms his own opinion about the athlete. Since everyone has different tastes, even with you, it is different. I love some gymnasts, you others, and some has the same taste and someone does not. And that's okay, that's how we should be all different. Well, in my opinion, today the commentators of Belarus were much more competent than the Russian ones. Although sometimes there was a feeling that they didn't understand everything in the world of gymnastics, but at least it was more pleasant to listen to them. It'll be interesting to know who will comment the Olympics and whether the broadcast will be without commentators. By the way, write in the comments which one do you like to watch, the broadcast with or without comments. Personally, I like to listen to interesting stories that the commentators tell about gymnasts, but when they start to extol someone and humiliate someone, I don't really like that. Express your opinion. Yes, please. But not in the format that they are the best, but in the format that I like them. Although, we will always compare all the athletes. Maybe their voices are just unpleasant to me, so it seems to me that they are discussing something unpleasant. Well, now that I have spoken out, you can move on to the results. So, the final with the hoop was won by Alina Gornosko. Since I have already said that I was looking for broadcast for almost the entire final with the hoop, there is nothing special to say. Silver was won by Anastasia Salas and bronze by Lala Kramarenko. Next came Daria Trubnikova, Nicole Zelikman, Elizaveta Polstinaya, Kristina Pogranichna and Salome Pajava closed the 8th in the final. The final with the ball was won by Alina Gornosko with a score of 28 and 6 cents. She went through her program really well and in one breath. Following her was Lala Kramarenko, also coped very well with her program today, and I really liked her performance. The elements were very clean and straight, without convergence. It is just amazing. And Anastasia Salas won the bronze, but Nastya, despite the fact that the whole exercise was going through very well with the apparatus and at a very fast pace. This is also an amazing exercise, and Nastya is beautiful, but at the end there was a small glitch, which in fact greatly influenced the assessment, and only bronze. Daria Trubnikova became the fourth, and she was only 500 short of bronze, but it is of course a very offensive and a very small margin, but Dasha was happy after the performance, so at least it pleases. The fifth was Nicole Zeligman from Israel, sixth Kristina Pogranichna, seventh was Salome Pajava, and eighth was a gymnast from Bulgaria, Tatiana Volozhanina. The final Swiss clubs was won again by Alina Gornosko. Having cleanly passed the program in general, this tournament for Alina turned out to be very good in terms of stability and in terms of medals. She did not reach the final with a ribbon, therefore such a wonderful end of the tournament. I'm very happy for Alina, she's really amazing and she's definitely loved by many people. The second was Lala Kramarenko, she also went pretty cleanly. And at first it even seemed to me that she was very impudent, in a good sense of the word, very confident and clear. But in the end, this feeling disappeared a little, but at first it took my breath away from Lala's pressure. The Israeli gymnast won the bronze. My dreams came true a little and Nicole received the bronze. She's very happy and amazing gymnast, very inert. Unfortunately, at most tournaments she does not have enough difficulty compared to others, but it's great that in a smaller tournament she can win medals. Kristina Pogranichna became fourth, Anastasia Salas took fifth place, she admitted a lot. The sixth place was taken by Adia Asikat, an Israeli gymnast. For the third day, I have been following her and I really like her. Salome Pajava in the final with clubs became seventh, and in the eighth place was Daria Trubnikova. Unfortunately, Dasha made mistakes, which lowers her so low in the rating. Well, the final with the ribbon was finally won by the Russian fans, by Lala Kramarenko. Lala cleanly passed her program, but the truth, and no one competed for her. And by the way, interesting documents from the tournament got into the network, where it's written according to the judges how the gymnasts are evaluated. And this just clearly shows that Lala lacks her complexity of the apparatus, and although her body is more than anyone else, it is yet not enough for the marks to be above. Alina Gornosko did not make it to the final with the ribbon, and Nastya Salas in the ribbon completely got confused because of which she became only second. Although I thought Nastya would be at lower at all. But apparently in terms of complexity, everything was not bad. The third place was also unexpectedly and pleasantly taken by Kristina Pogranichna, gymnast from Ukraine, and after this it will even be a shame if she does not go to the Olympics. Kristina is very clever today, and I'm glad that she finished the tournament with a medal. The fourth in the tape was Salome Pajava, in fifth place was Nicole Zeligman, sixth was Elizabeta Polosnaya, and seventh place was Daria Trubnikova, who made quite a few serious mistakes in the tape, and Tatiana Volozhanina closed the top 8. She dropped and missed the ribbon even more. Well, to the group. To start with minor edits from yesterday, as it turned out, the national team of Uzbekistan did not allow losses yesterday. Apparently on the broadcast it seemed that the object touched the floor. I rewound and watched this moment several times, and apparently all the same the girls performed the exercise without losses. And now to the results. In the final with 5 balls, the gold was won by the gymnast of Bulgaria, gaining a score of 48 and 8 tenths, which of course is simply amazing. I really like girls' suits and in general the setting with balls. And by the way, at the award ceremony I noticed that one of the group girls had a golden shiny manicure, just as I love and stars in my ears. My laugh is direct. The second were Israeli gymnasts. The team of Belarus took the third place, having passed the final well, but they were clearly dissatisfied with the assessment. This is, by the way, to the question of what they are pulling. If they were pulling, I think the team of Belarus would not regret higher marks. Well, the team of Uzbekistan scored the same assessment as the team of Belarus, but Uzbekistan lost in execution. It's a shame. I really love this team, especially remembering how they have changed and grown in recent 3 years. The final with the hoops and clubs was won by the Israeli gymnast, and the Bulgarian team became second, which they were clearly not happy with, and even filed a protest. Although it was rejected and the gymnast remained in second place. The team of Uzbekistan won bronze medals and the team of Belarus became only fourth. In general, in group competition is simply incredible and I can't even predict who will be on podium. And another addition about future links, you very often ask to where to watch broadcasts. I publish all the links in the Telegram channel. Who does not have it, put nothing there, and you can follow all the news in express mode, where the results usually appear earlier. The fact is that on YouTube, when you publish posts with links, YouTube minimizes blog posts because YouTube does not want me to take viewers from their side to another. Therefore, it is better for you and me that you turn to the Telegram channel for links. This is simply Messenger, in which you can follow my chats as a news feed. Well, more recently I created a community on Facebook and also tried to publish links there, but for now I forgot the Telegram. So Telegrams are at the moment 100% likely to get a link to the competition. Find out everything first. There's a link to my group under each video on YouTube. Join and you can turn off notifications so as not to infuriate and not distract from your business. And enter only when it's convenient for you. And find out what is interesting happening in the world of the gymnast. And lastly, today in the Kiss and Cry age as well as the European Championship, there was again the girls' favorite music. I like this innovation, even though we see the girls happy. Well, that's it for today. I'll see you very soon in the next video. Remember that I love you all, and for now, goodbye. Video was translated and dubbed by Sasha Sinica.